Hi there.
Hello. Thanks
How
for
are
joining
you?
me.
Of course, thanks for having me.
Yeah, how's everything going?
Hanging in there, not going many places these days. How about
Oh,
you?
yeah. Same story. Are you in New York City? Okay, I'm just north in Boston.
Oh, very cool. It didn't snow today, so that's a first for the past couple of days. It's been pretty
Same
crazy.
here.
So,
Yeah.
yeah.
I'm counting down the days until spring.
Yes. I haven't seen this much snow, at least in this area, in a while. So, yeah,
Yeah.
it was cool for the first few days, and now it's like, all right, I get it. I get it.
Exactly.
Yes.
Same sentiments here.
Yes.
Well, I want to congratulate you guys on the latest single, Cruel Heart. I'm loving
You?
it.
Thank you. Yeah, I'm really happy we were finally able to release it. It's been a song I've been excited about for a while now, so I'm glad everyone can hear it.
Yeah, so you guys performed it before and then decided to release it as a single.
Yes. So I co-wrote this song with Keith Wallen from Breaking Benjamin and also an amazing solo artist in his own right. And we did it a while ago. And before we even got to record it, I went on a bunch of tours with the band and we thought that we should, test it out, see how the crowds would respond to it. And everyone seemed to really like it and relate to it, and that meant a lot to me. So once we got that reaction, we knew, okay, we have to go, we have to, record this, and we have to release it. So it was a pretty cool process because we don't usually do it that way.
Yeah, usually it's like the opposite, right?
Exactly.
And now it's being added to all these really cool Spotify playlists, so that's amazing.
I feel really fortunate that people are picking it up and are really listening to it and enjoying it, and that some of these playlists, they thought the song was cool enough to add to. It means a lot to see such great response for this song. It's meant a lot to me for so long, and now to have other people, wanting to spread the word, it's pretty awesome.
Yeah, that is awesome. And when you write with Keith, how is the writing relationship? Is it, do you tend to come up with more of the melodies or the lyrics, or is it kind of like split 50-50?
Well, for a lot of the stuff that we do, it really is a 50-50 situation, but it's never the same way every time, and that's the same in all of my songwriting processes. Like whoever I'm working with, even if it's someone I've worked with a million times over, every time you get into that room together, there's something different's going to happen. It's never going to be the same, routine each time. So, with this song, we kind of just sat down and started to come up with some ideas, and it just kind of happened. It happened pretty quickly too, which was really awesome. The song just really came together really well.
That's cool. And what about the music video experience? Because you're doing running in it, so,
Oh, yeah.
was it tough or was it, fun?
It was definitely really fun, especially since we shot the video more recently. So to be able to be out and running around in New York City after being cooped up for so long was really cool. And we did it with 1 RPM Studios, and they are fantastic. And basically went to Brooklyn first, shot all of the studio shots, the performance shots, and then in my performance outfit, like with the huge platforms and everything, go out into Manhattan and just start running. And it was like the first time I had real cardio in so long because of this pandemic, and because we haven't really been going anywhere. So normally I run around on stage like a maniac, and so I always try to keep up, my exercise and my stamina, but obviously that's fallen off a little bit during this time. So being able to run around New York City was really exciting, but also like I found myself like, okay, get 1 second before the next take. Hold on. Let me just, okay, I can do this. I can do this. And but it was really cool. And New York, it's awesome because you can run around dressed as I was and no one cares. No one batted an eyelash. They were like, oh, okay, cool.
Just another music video.
Yep, exactly.
And was it kind of like a little bit more emptier because of COVID, like less people on the streets?
Well, it was very
Or was
cold
it done
that day.
before?
Well, it was very cold that day actually, and it was done very, I think it was done, we did it back in actually like in January, and so it was just cold. So there were still people though. You'd be surprised, especially now that everyone's stuck inside in apartments and things like that. Everyone wants to get outside. So on the more pedestrian, areas near parks, things like that, those shots, there were people everywhere. But then of course, when we went to some of the side streets, they were completely empty. So it's interesting. Like when all this stuff started to happen, the streets were completely empty in New York. And now I feel like slowly but surely, you know, they're starting to repopulate the streets. So that's kind of cool. Yeah.
Well, that's cool. And so what's coming up next for Madame Mayhem that people should be on the lookout for?
Well, we are hoping to release more music over this year until we know when we can tour again. We recorded a bunch of stuff prior to this pandemic hitting, prior to our last tour, actually, which was about a year ago. And we were hoping to maybe get a full album together, you know, before releasing some of these songs. But given the situation that we're in now and wanting to still connect with our fans and share this music that we've had for a while that we're very excited about, you know, there will definitely be some more singles on their way to everybody, and some more virtual, you know, performances as much as we can do. We might be part of some more virtual festivals coming up soon. So I would just recommend for fans to keep in touch with me on social media or check out madamayhem.com. And as soon as, you know, any of those things gets announced, we will tell you guys right away.
That's cool. Thank God for the internet, because then we would be completely you know, live music.
It's amazing how, you know, how we've had to adapt during this time. You know, I never would have thought that I would do, you know, a virtual festival like I did like earlier last year, like just with my keyboard and like so stripped down. That's not really the style that we're used to doing. And it was kind of cool because you got to show fans, you know, a different side of yourself. So I kind of liked it, but of course I miss live shows and I can't wait to get back out there soon and rock out and really, you know, feel the energy of everybody. Yeah. But until then, we'll just keep releasing music and keep trying to interact on social media and, you know, appreciate everyone's support in, you know, streaming our music still while, you know, you wait for even more new stuff, and, you know, every little bit helps. So.
Absolutely. Yeah. I've been reminiscing about last concerts I went to before COVID. There any concerts that you attended that you look back to fondly, like, oh, I miss that?
Oh, there are so many. the last concert that I actually went to was actually one of ours, because we literally finished our tour last February. It ended at the end of February, around this time exactly. And then we didn't really have a lot of weeks in between before, you know, before all of this happened. And so I think the last thing I did besides that tour was this jam night with all these other artists. And that was really cool because you get to, you know, interact with so many cool musicians, and I got to see it felt like a mini reunion, and it was really cool. And so just thinking back on being able to like hang out with the band and hang out with other fellow musicians and fellow rock fans and just, you know, being able to enjoy, you know, music, which we all love so much and have made it our, you know, our lives. Can't wait to do that again.
Yeah, because it's like a community, you know, like a family. Yeah,
it almost. Really is. It really is. I always say that because besides just being an artist, I'm also a huge, you know, rock and metal fan. And so I am part of that family and that community of just being a rock and metal fan as well. And so I really do feel like everyone who, you know, loves live music is part of my family as well.
That's cool. And are there any like newer rock bands that you're really digging at the moment?
I love just watching and finding all this new stuff. It's whether it's old or new. So what I've been doing is just like listening to so many different things, whether it's on Spotify or wherever it may be. Thinking back to older music or bands that maybe I didn't you know, think about at the time or didn't discover yet, and rediscovering those kind of artists, I think has been really fun. And there are so many new up and coming bands that, that you find while doing that, that you're like, oh, you got to check out this brand new band. It's like, no, like they've been around for a while. And that's, yeah. And I find that with me too, actually, you know, some people have reached out to me during this time, like, hey, like love your music. Like you must be like brand new on the scene. It's like, sure. Yep.
Like, brand new to you maybe.
Yeah, exactly. But I think that's what's so cool about it now is like, you know, what might be someone's like go-to band for the past couple of years is someone's brand new, you know, exciting, you know, project that they want to share with all their friends. And so I've just been listening to as much music as humanly possible during this time.
Yeah, same here. Yeah, I have some friends who are really big rock fans as well, and they're always showing me new music, and I'm like, well, they've been around for so long, but I'm just hearing about them now. But it's good. It's great to have fresh music to listen to.
Exactly.
And do you have like a venue or a city that you haven't performed at yet that you're hoping to get to eventually?
I mean, we've performed in so many places, but there's also so many parts of the world that we haven't gotten to yet. And so I do want to try to hit as many, you know, places as humanly possible. I mean, my dream is always to, you know, come back to New York City and play at Madison Square Garden one day. But, you know, as for locations, like we haven't been to Asia yet to play. We haven't been, we got to do this amazing European and UK tour a few years back, which was pretty exciting. And so, you know, to also be able to travel internationally or Australia, you know, some of these places where we haven't been able to play yet and just kind of spread our music out, I would love to do. And there's a lot of places in the States too, where we haven't actually been able to go yet. Like we've been to so many states and so many cities, and it's been really cool when we get to repeat those places, because then you get to like reconnect with those fans that saw you, you know, the first time and the second time. But you know, really anywhere. The stage is my life, and so wherever I can play, I will be extremely happy.
That's true. Yeah.
Yeah.
And is there anything like on your bucket list musically that you would love to do, like whether it be contribute to a movie soundtrack or a video game or something like that?
Yeah, I mean, all that's really fun. I mean, for me, when I was studying music in school, besides performance, I was also studying composition. And so to be able to compose something that maybe goes into a different realm of media one day is something I'm definitely interested in doing.
Yeah, that would be fun.
Yeah, and I think it would be.
I've realized like a lot of classic rock bands that I love actually did music for like these soundtracks back in the 80s, and I had no idea.
Yeah, and there's a lot of rock artists that do a lot of movie scoring that like you wouldn't know unless you checked, and like it's pretty cool. So yeah, I would love to one day you know, branch out and try, you know, all the different realms of music, you know, and all the different outlets that I can do.
Yeah, sky's the limit.
Yep, exactly.
And I saw that you have new merch up on your store for the songs. That's pretty cool.
Yeah. We wanted to do something cool for fans besides, of course, releasing the song and the video, which, you know, are the most important things, but thought it would be kind of fun to design some additional new merch to throw out on the web store, you know, some hoodies, things like that for the winter time, since it has been very cold, at least in our area. Yep. Lately. And so we did a launch as well for that, and everyone can check that out at the madammayhem.com store.
Yeah, they look pretty cool. I'm going to have to get one.
Yeah, I'm focusing on my order too. So I'm like, I keep telling people like, we're all going to be twinsies. I'm going to wear the same stuff you guys are going to wear.
That's awesome. Yeah. Well, I really appreciate your time. It's been a blast chatting with you, and I can't wait to see, you know, the upcoming songs that you guys have, you know, in the pipeline.
Oh, thank you so much. Yeah, I really appreciate this. This has been fun.